Good morning, students. In the last video, we had learned about windmills, how wind energy can be trapped and converted into electrical energy. We had also seen some non-conventional sources of energy. Today, we are going to learn in detail about non-conventional sources of energy. So let us start with today's lesson, which will be a continued part of sources of energy. Non-conventional sources of energy. So first in that list is solar energy. So sun has been radiating an enormous amount of energy at present for nearly 5 billion years and will continue radiating at that rate for about more 5 billion years. Only a small part of solar energy reaches the outer layer of Earth's atmosphere. Now remember that though it is a small part, the small part is also enough for us to use it and convert into some another form of energy. Nearly half of it is absorbed while passing through the atmosphere and the rest reaches the Earth's surface. So relatively we get very little amount of solar energy, but as I said, even that is enough for us to convert into some useful form of energy. There are few facts about solar energy which are related to India, and that is India is lucky to receive enough energy for greater part of the year. Remember that all the countries are not that lucky. It is estimated that during a year we receive around 5000 trillion kilowatt hour of energy, which is more than enough. On a clear sky conditions, daily we receive around 4 to 7 kilowatt hour per meter square. So this is more than enough. We receive enough energy. Only the condition or only the fact is that we are not, the technology is not that developed to convert this amount of solar energy into electricity or into any other form of energy. We are trying right now, but we can make use of solar energy even more than that, even more than today. So we have enough opportunity, only that we have to use a technology fully so that we can use this solar energy and convert it into electricity and use it for the betterment of our society. Let us learn few more things about solar energy. The first thing is the black surface absorbs more heat as compared to white or reflecting surface under identical conditions. So this property can be used in certain devices like solar cookers and solar water heaters. So this is an example of solar cooker. The food to be cooked is kept in this box, and then there is a mirror, and this inside the box it is entirely colored black because of the fact that black surface absorbs more heat compared to any other surface. Some solar cookers achieve a high temperature by using mirrors to focus the rays of the sun. So here there is a mirror which can reflect the light rays and increase the temperature. And last point is solar cookers are covered with a glass plate so that it absorbs even more energy. Students, remember that these devices like solar cooker or solar water heater can be used only during certain time of the day because it depends on availability of the sun, and sun is only for a certain time of the day. So what about rest part of the day? This limitation of using solar energy is overcome by using solar cells that convert solar energy into electricity. So this is a solar cell panel. Now after seeing this picture you must have identified, because these panels are installed even in villages, in remote areas. So one time or other you might have seen these solar cell panels. So these are basically solar cells, and the panel is made up of silicon plates The silicon absorbs a solar energy and then it converts it into electricity. A typical cell develops a voltage of 0.5 to 1 volts and can produce about 0.7 watt of electricity when exposed to sun. Large number of solar cells are combined in an arrangement called solar cell panel. So here there are large number of solar cells which are arranged in particular manner. These are called a solar cell panel, and they can deliver enough electricity for practical use. So that was related to solar energy. Now we will learn about energy from sea, how to obtain energy from sea. And first in that is tidal energy. Because of gravitational pull of moon on spinning earth, the level of water in sea rises and falls down. This phenomena is called high tide and low tide. This tidal energy can be used to run a turbine and thus convert it into electrical energy. So, due to gravitational pull of moon on spinning earth, the level of water in sea rises and falls, which we know it as high tide and low tide. And this difference in sea level gives us tidal energy. The tidal energy is harnessed by constructing a dam across a narrow opening to the sea. A turbine is fixed at the opening of the dam that converts tidal energy into electricity. Energy from sea can be obtained in other way also, and that other way is wave energy. This particular plant can be used to harness wave energy. The kinetic energy possessed by huge waves can be trapped just like in earlier case and can be used to obtain electricity. So, the kinetic energy possessed by huge waves near seashore can be trapped in a similar manner to generate electricity. The waves are generated by strong winds blowing across the sea. Wave energy would be viable proposition only where waves are very strong. So, this is a limitation. We cannot use it everywhere. Wherever waves are strong, only there we can use wave energy to convert it into electricity. The last point is, a wide variety of devices have been developed to trap wave energy for rotation of turbine and thus production of electricity. Now comes the last part, which is ocean thermal energy. This particular animation is a sort of schematic diagram that represents a plant that uses ocean thermal energy to convert it into electricity. The water at the surface of the sea gets heated up because of sun, while water in deeper section is still relatively cold. This difference in temperature can be used to obtain electricity using a volatile liquids like ammonia that gets converted into a vapor at relatively low temperature. This vapor can then be used to run turbine and hence generate electricity. Let us study about this plant in detail. The water at the surface of the sea or ocean is heated by sun, just like I said earlier, while water in deeper section is relatively cold. The difference in temperature is exploited to obtain energy in ocean thermal energy conversion plants. This plant can operate if the temperature difference between water at the surface and water at the depth up to 2 kilometers is around 20 Kelvin. Okay. The warm surface water is used to boil a volatile liquid like ammonia. This ammonia is very volatile. It gets converted into vapor form at relatively low temperatures. The vapor of the liquid are then used to run the turbine of generator. The cold water from the depth of the ocean is pumped up and then it is used to condense this vapor to liquid form. Well, that was all for today. Let us see the assignment. Write a short note on solar energy. Explain with example and diagram. So this point we already discussed. Second question is, what are the advantages and limitations of solar energy? Now students, this you have to find it on your own, either by using textbook or using some reference book. You have to find advantages and limitations of solar energy by your own. If you don't find, well, it's okay. I will tell you later on during when I will give you answer key. But until then, you have to try it by yourself. And the last question is, explain how we can make use of energy from sea with the help of example. So you have to answer this question also, and points related to this question have already been discussed. So I think that will be easy for you. So that was today's assignment. See you in next video. Until then, take care. Bye bye.